Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and today I'm going to discuss the book Turtles All the Way Down by John Green. I have decided that I'm going to divide this discussion into four parts. The first part will be the general basic summary of the book. The second part will be the inner meaning or the main, actually the real plot behind the novel, and the third part will be how much or how far has the author succeeded into portraying the real plot of the story, and the fourth part will be my take on the book, like how much I liked it. So yeah, let's get started.
The book looks like, it's quite big and it's gorgeous. I love how this book looks from the front. The cover page is just gorgeous, and it has been published by the Penguin Publishers. You can see the logo over here, and this is quite big. It's
All the Way Down is a young adult novel, and the protagonist of the book is Aza Holmes. She's a 16-year-old girl, and she has a best friend. Her name is Daisy. Now the story revolves around Aza. Like, she is the narrator of the book, she is the one with whose perspective the book has been written, and she has some serious mental issues of OCD and anxiety, and she deals with them throughout the book. Now the story has different layers to it. The main the root, the path of the story begins from these two, Aza and Daisy. They get to know that there is this billionaire. He has been missing, and people have been finding him, and there is a reward if you find him. So the reward is of $100,000, and so these two people are after the reward. These two people want that much amount of money because that will pay for their education and everything, and that's why they are now pursuing towards this adventure of finding Mr. Pickett. Now Mr. Pickett is the father of Aza's old friend Davis. So these two basically go to Pickett's house, and they are caught by the security guard there, and he takes them to Davis, where Aza and Davis finally get along with each other. And after that, these two get into a relationship. Now a lot of things happen that leads to it. Now these two are now in a relationship, and so this is how the story has been pursued into. Okay, so now this is not the main story of the novel. The treasure hunting thing comes to a halt all of a sudden. Like, you thought that the story was about money and everything, but no, it is not. It is based, it is something else. It has a deeper layer to it. There are a lot of layers in the story, and that makes me love the story even more. Now the thing is ki these two people are in a relationship, but Aza has some serious mental issues of anxiety and OCD, and it affects her life a lot. It affects her life in ways that she gets into these tight overthinking spirals, and she just cannot get out of it. One thought leads to another, and then that leads to another, and she is into a thought spiral, and it affects her life a lot. But her relationship with Davis, or this is not just a love story, this is more than that. This is peeling off a person's layer of mental illness. That's why this book is very important. This book also talks a lot about the relationship between Aza and her best friend Daisy. It speaks a lot about friendship. And this book is not just from the perspective of a person who is dealing with anxiety and OCD, but this book also talks a lot about how it affects the people who love people who are fighting mental illness. So it's not just one perspective that you are being given to see. You are basically given a whole view of how this thing affects a lot of people, a group of people, and how it is very important to just talk about it and just understand it in a better way. So this is what the story continues. Now, after that, and Azar meet on a regular basis and they talk about it, about different things, but Davis realizes that Azar is after the prize money, the reward money, and he offers her $1 lakh that she accepts, and that she and Daisy splits into between each other. So this happens, and even Aza realizes that this relationship with Davis is not going to work because she is not normal. She has her issues with mental illness, and she can just never be with him in a normal sense. He writes a continuous blog, and he in that blog he writes about his father, how he misses him, and how and what he feels for Aza. He writes about everything that goes on in his life in a very beautiful way, that and Aza reads that blog on a continuous basis. So from there she gets to know how much he actually misses his father, and how much he actually adores Aza, and how much he just understands her. That is one way that we get to see a different side of it, about how these two people may not be able to communicate with each other because of Aza's mental health, but through his blogs he communicates so much to her, and she gets to understand so much, and it doesn't even make her feel anxious. Also, she comes across this fan fiction blog that her best friend Daisy writes about Star Wars, and she realizes that Daisy has been using Aza as a character in a fan fiction to vent out all her frustration that she gets in while she deals with her. And that is what is very important, that this book doesn't only talk about the mental health of the person, but it also tells us how the other people who surround you, the one who is dealing with mental health, these people are also affected by it, and how much they have to tolerate, and how much frustration it leads them to, and yet they do not give up on you. So that is a very beautiful thing that I like about this book, that it does not just give you one perspective. It gives you a whole wide view of this whole thing, that how much mental illness is a problem and how much it is important for people to communicate with each other. So that blog, after reading it, Aza feels very vulnerable, that oh my god, her best friend has been feeling like this, and she has made her best friend feel so frustrated. But she cannot do anything about it, and she obviously, as a normal human being, she gets really angry, and there are some issues between them, and they are driving to somewhere, and then they start fighting. That leads to an accident, and Aza is admitted in the hospital, but she recovers, and after her recovery, she and her best friend Daisy, they get along again, apologizes for everything that they have done to each other, and it's a beautiful thing. On the other hand, the whole mystery of Davis's father's missing gets solved somehow. I will not tell you about it because I think that is something that is that should be kept, or I think it will be a spoiler to give you. So that happens, and I think the ending is pretty good. It's pretty happy, and it will make you good. It's a feel good novel. At the end, like the ending is beautiful. It's really nice. So this is the whole story. Now there's a lot to tell about it, because the story has a lot of layers to it, and it talks a lot about a lot of things. So it's not just one story, it has different stories, and that's why I think this book is great. Now coming to the third part, how much John Green has succeeded in putting across all these stories. I think, in my perspective, the book has been written very beautifully. Like, you can totally understand the problem, the vulnerability, and the miserableness of Aza. How much you will feel her. You will feel how much it affects her. That she knows that this is all in her mind, but she cannot help it. And that is the problem with mental illness, that you know that it's in your mind, it's in your brain. It's not happening, but you cannot help it. And that's what it is all about. So I think he has put it across well. If you are someone who has dealt with OCD or anxiety or any kind of mental illness, you are going to relate with this. You will understand exactly what is happening with Aza. But if you are someone who has not dealt with it, I think it is important for you as well, because maybe someone is out there in your life who is dealing with all these things, and it will help you understand them better. So this book is important for everyone because mental illness is something that is very important today, and a lot of people, 35% of people in this world are depressed. Depression is a huge thing. Then there's anxiety and everything, and we should be more open about all these things. So yeah, I think John Green has completely succeeded in putting through the struggle of a person dealing with all these things. Now I think there were a lot of things that was going on in this book, and he did justice to it. I found it good, so it was really nice. Now coming to the last part of the discussion, how much I liked it. Now I will tell you that the title of the book, Turtles All the Way Down, why turtles and everything, you will be given your answer in the book. He has explained why, like, you will get to know why it is called Turtles All the Way Down. And I have loved that concept. I loved how he actually incorporated this whole thing and the title. It just justifies, and I loved it. I am personally a huge fan of John Green, and he is one of my favorite writers. John Green's books are something about the journey. If you're someone who reads a book to go to the end to find out what's going to happen in the end, I think then obviously his books are going to disappoint you. But if you're someone who loves the journey through it, who loves to read each and every line, every quote, every sentence, each and every book is going to make you feel really good, because his books are all about the journey. It's all about the time you invested in reading it. So if you're someone who loves investing your time into a book in the most real sense, that you read it, you actually absorb each and every word in your system and just live it in that moment, then this book is going to make you feel really good. I know there are a lot of people who are going to tell you that Turtles All the Way Down is not as great as The Fault in Our Stars. Now, obviously, the two books are very different. You cannot compare the two books. But I'm just going to tell you that Turtles All the Way Down is a special book, and it should be read by everyone in their lifetime. So this was my take on this book. If you liked my review or not a review, basically, if you liked my discussion on this book, then do click on the like button. And I have planned on that I'm going to upload a video on Stoicism or Stoicism, whatever you pronounce it, and how you can use this whole theory in dealing with heartbreak and any kind of tragedy. So I'm going to upload that video really soon. So if you want to watch that video, or if you just really liked the thing that you saw till now, then do click on the subscribe button and also the bell icon. Only then you will be notified that I uploaded a video. And till then, thank you, goodbye.